The next academic year, there will be excursions and field trips, fortunately. Of course, that's the way it is now, and circumstances are changing constantly, but we are planning to let them continue. Excursions and field trips are a very important aspect of our education, because it's outside where you see it happening, whether that is in the nature areas itself, in reserves, or at organizations of different kinds, such as municipalities, non-governmental organizations, or commercial organizations. So yes, they will continue, and we're glad about that. Of course, we have to take special measures in order to let these excursions continue. One of the most important measures that we have to comply with is the 1.5 meter distance. That is very important. So going into the field, for instance, with a group of 50 students, you need a lot of space. And it is also vital that you can hear the lecturer, you know, explaining what you can see. So therefore, we purchased many walkie-talkies. So the teacher can be heard. The information is loud and clear for students, taking into account the 1.5 meter distance. And it's even possible for students to communicate back to the lecturer to ask questions, for instance. We make sure that that our excursions and fieldwork comply with all Corona measures. Another example is we check a health check prior to the excursion. And for international excursions, of course, we do it during the excursion and after the excursion as well. Right before the start of the excursion, there will be a final check, a final go moment, to see if it's still possible to go. As I just mentioned, the international excursions are continuing as well, at least we hope so. Of course, these excursions ask special measures. So for all these excursions, we perform a risk assessment, and official approval by the Dean of Education is necessary. And we pay special attention about risk assessment on transportation, accommodation, what do you do in your leisure time, what's the vicinity of healthcare, what do you do if somebody is tested positively, do they have to be in isolation, we book extra rooms, we go with two buses instead of one, so the 1.5 meter distance can be taken into account at all times. So yeah, it requires an extra effort, but we aim to let these international excursions continue as well. Well, of course, we run the risk that an excursion has to be cancelled at a late moment due to a change in circumstances. Therefore, we are already thinking about alternative programs. It is also possible that a student cannot join the excursion due to health issues, mild symptoms. So also for those situations, we have alternative programs available. Luckily, we can use the experience gained in period 6, the last period from the previous academic year, in which we designed individual assignments for students in the field, where they could also meet lecturers. And we are also conducting an experiment with live streaming with the use of GoPro cameras, and hopefully that will be successful as well.